जय हिंद एवरीवन. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग माय टुडेज लेक्चर आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू दैट इट मे बी पॉसिबल दैट द एनिमेटेड वे विच आई हैव यूज्ड इन माय दिस वीडियो मे लुक चाइल्डिश फॉर मेनी ऑफ माय व्यूअर्स बट फॉर दोज हु लाइक दिस एनिमेटेड वे प्लीज टेल मी थ्रू द कमेंट सेक्शन सो आई कैन गेट मोटिवेटेड टू मेक मोर सच वीडियोज. ओके, इट लुक्स चाइल्डिश बट ट्रस्ट मी इट टुक अ लॉट ऑफ एफर्ट टू प्रिपेयर सच अ वीडियो फॉर अ पर्सन लाइक मी who doesn't know much about the technologies and apps which are being used these days. I spent a lot of time to see what YouTube tutorials and to learn the functioning of these apps which I have used in my videos. I would also like to tell that every single thing, whether it is editing, recording, uploading or voiceover, sound recording, everything in my video is done by me and me only. So it took a lot of efforts for me, and if you appreciate my work, I will get motivated to make more such animated videos for the welfare of the students. So let us start our today's topic, which is related to the some theorems or properties of subspaces in a different new animated way. Okay, let's start.
Hello friends, I am Vector Space VF. Meet my subspaces W1 and W2.
I am a little bit confused. Let me tell you about my problem. My subsets W1 union W2 and W1 intersection W2 are having an argument. Let's see their problem.
I am a subspace of yours, that is VF. No. It's not true. It is me who is actually a subspace of yours.
Oh, how to resolve this issue? Yes, I have an idea. I will call Dr. R. Jaiswal. She will really help me. Ma'am, could you please help me to solve this problem?
It will be my pleasure if I could help you, Mr. Vector Space VF.
We have a Vector Space VF and its two subspaces W1 and W2, subspaces of VF. We have to show that, we have to prove that W1 intersection W2 is also a subspace of vector space V. Okay? This is our vector space VF and it has two subspaces W1 and W2. We will see that W1 and W2 can't be disjoint. Okay, they will have a common element, and that is the zero element. Okay, to prove W1 intersection W2 is a subspace of V, first of all we have to show that W1 intersection W2 is a non-empty subset of V. Okay, so it is obvious that W1 intersection W2 is a subset of V, since both W1 and W2 are subsets of V. Okay, both are non-empty subsets of V. So it is confirmed that W1 intersection W2 is also a subset of V. It will also be a non-empty subset because at least zero element is present in W1, and zero element is also present in W2 for the internal operation plus, and therefore zero belongs to W1 intersection W2. This means this subset W1 intersection W2 of V has at least one element zero. Okay, so it is a non-empty subset of V. To prove that this is a subspace of V, we have to show that for any AB in the field F and any vectors alpha beta in this W1 intersection W2, we have A alpha plus B beta also belongs to W1 intersection W2. If we are able to prove this, then it will imply that W1 intersection W2 is also a subspace of vector space V. Okay, so let us prove this. We see that for A and B in field F and alpha and beta in W1 intersection W2, it implies that alpha and beta belongs to W1 and alpha and beta belongs to W2. because alpha and beta are in the intersection of both these non-empty sets. So alpha and beta will be available in both W1 and in W2, then they are coming in their intersection. Okay. Now we have AB in field F and alpha beta in W1. So by the condition of subspace, since W1 is a subspace of B, we have A alpha plus B beta belongs to W1. Okay. Now next we come to A and B belongs to F and we have alpha beta in W2. Okay. So this implies A alpha plus B beta is also present in W2. Since W2 is a subspace and we know if W2 is a subspace, then this condition will be satisfied in W2. Okay. Now since A alpha plus B beta is present in W1 and it is also an element of W2, that is, it is common element of W1 and W2, so it implies that A alpha plus B beta belongs to W1 intersection W2, where A and B are any two scalars and alpha beta are any two vectors in the set W1 intersection W2, which implies W1 intersection W2 is a subspace of V. By the condition of being a subspace which we have discussed in the previous lecture. Okay, so we can say that intersection of two subspaces of a vector space is also a vector space, is also subspace of that vector space. Okay, but if we talk about the union of two subspaces, then it is not necessary that union of two subspaces is also a subspace of that vector space. That is, if V is a vector space and W1 and W2 are subspaces of V, then it is not necessary that W1 union W2 is also a subspace of V. It is not necessary. It may be a subspace of V, it may not be a subspace of V. Let us check it. Let us take the vector space V, F equal R cube R, the set of all triplets of real number which forms a vector space over the field of real numbers, and let us take the subspaces W1 equal the set of triplets alpha 1, alpha 2, 0, which we have discussed in our previous lectures, and subspace W2 equal alpha 1, 0, alpha 3, where alpha 1 and alpha 3 are real numbers. We have shown in our previous lectures that both W1 and W2 are subspaces of this vector space R cube R. Now we have W1, we have to show that W1 union W2 is not a subspace of R cube R. Okay? So let us take any two elements of W1 union W2. Let us take element alpha equal 1, 2, 0 in W1. Okay, because alpha is an element which has a triplet, which is a triplet of real number whose third element is a 0, and so it belongs to W1. Now let us take another element beta in the subspace W2, which is of the form 2, 0, 3. Now we have alpha plus beta. We have clearly alpha and beta belongs to W1 union W2. We clearly have alpha beta belongs to W1 union W2. Why? Because alpha is in W1 and beta is in W2. So alpha and beta both are present in the union of W1 and W2. Now we see that alpha plus beta equals 1, 2, 0 plus 2, 0, 3. Which gives us 2 plus 1, 3, 2 plus 0, 2, and 3 plus 0 means 3. This new element doesn't belong to W1 union W2. Why? Because this particular element 3, 2, 3 is neither present in W1 and nor in the subspace W2. This particular element 3, 2, 3 is neither an element of W1, neither an element of W2. Why? Because to be an element of W1, to be an element of W1, the third coordinate of the triplet, third element of the triplet should be 0, but it is not 0. So this is not an element of W1. Similarly, to be an element of W2, the second element, second real number in the triplet should be 0. But here we see that the second element in the triplet is not 0, so it doesn't belong to W2. This means 3 to 3, which is equal to alpha plus beta, doesn't belong to W1 union W2. This means closure law is not being satisfied in this particular subset of a vector space VF, which implies W1 union W2 is not a subspace, because closure law for addition and scalar multiplication is a necessary and sufficient condition for a subspace W of a vector space V to be a subspace of V. But here the closure law of addition is not being satisfied in the union, in the set W1 union W2. So W1 union W2 is not a subspace of vector space VF. Okay, so we have seen in this particular case that union of two subspaces is not necessarily a subspace of VF, but there is a condition in which the union of two subspaces may be a subspace of the given vector space. For example, in the previous case of vector space RQ bar, if we have taken the subspace W1 as alpha1, alpha2, 0, triplets of real numbers whose third element is fixed to real number 0 and first and second elements are any real numbers alpha1 and alpha2, and if we have taken the subspace W2 as alpha1, 0, 0, where alpha1 is any real number, in this case it is triplets of all real numbers whose second and third element real numbers are fixed to the real number 0 and first element may be any real number, then in this case we see that W2 is properly contained in W1. W2 is a subset of W1. In this case, if we take W1 union W2, we see that W1 contains W2. So in this case, if we take union W1 union W2, then we get W1, and the W1 and W2 are subspaces of RQ bar. So, since W1 is a subspace, it implies W1 union W2 is also a subspace. Okay, so we see that in some cases, the union of two subspaces may be a subspace of the given vector space, or in some cases, some other cases, it may not be a subspace of the vector space. Okay, the condition under which the union will be a subspace of the vector space, we will discuss about it in our next lecture. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now my doubt is clear. W1 intersection W2, you are always a subspace of mine.
Wow, I knew it. Thank you, sir.
W1 union W2, you may or may not be a subspace of mine. It depends on certain conditions, which will be discussed later.
Okay, sir. Thank you.